The Wizard say, Wendy, that they will not hire a new president before the start of free agency. We keep hearing the name Masai Ujiri around that. What does all this mean?
There's no doubt that they wanted Masai Ujiri and went after Masai Ujiri, but it's not going to work out for them, so they're moving on. And this has not gone well for the Wizards. They have a top 10 pick. Half their team is a free agent. They tried to get Tim Connolly away from Denver. It didn't work out. They tried to get Masai Ujiri away from Toronto. It didn't work out. They are now not exactly.
When you talk about situations that are in flux, this goes to my point. Don't cry for the Lakers. The Knicks are going to actually be okay. Washington is a team that I worry about. When you're going into the draft and you don't have a president, that means you don't have a vision. Who's going to pick the player? Who's going to build around Bradley Beal? What's going to happen with John Wall's injury? You need somebody making that decision.
And Greeny, how about this? If a guy turns down $10 million a year and equity within a franchise, that has to say something.
I don't know if he actually got equity, but
okay.
I do believe.
Well, that was the rumor.
I do believe $10 million a year was what Masai could have gotten.
So, Wendy, what about the Clippers in all of this as it relates to Kawhi? Because all the rumors have said that he's going to go to the Clippers. Are they starting to worry at all that maybe he stays in Toronto?
You know, the Clippers have a great organization, and outwardly they will be very calm and they'll be fine. But interiorly, they're hyperventilating right now. I mean, because I really do believe, I think Kawhi will give the Knicks a look. There's a relationship between his...
Wait, say that again, please.
A look. I think Kawhi will
give the Knicks a look.
We'll give the Knicks
a look. Oh, suddenly the Knicks keep coming into the conversation.
See, this is why we don't say anything during the pre-show meeting anymore.
Greeny's hyperventilating.
Wait, can we just say that one more time? Kawhi will give the Knicks a look.
I believe that Kawhi will give the Knicks a look, but I think his decision is going to be staying with the Raptors, likely what I think is on a short deal, a 1+1 deal, which will let them roll it back. They can bring their whole team back. Or look at the L.A. Clippers, where he could invest in going forward.
You hear that?
Yes.
1+1 deal.
Right.
Not 5-year deal. Now you control your destiny. You keep it short. And next year, we're going to be still having the same conversation. That's what LeBron has done to us. That's what KD has done to us. He got New Balance money now, Greeny.
Run it back, Greeny. Well, it back with the Raptors again for a year.
Listen, I am all for it. And I want to make it clear, no one is more in favor of every player getting every penny that he or she can than I am. 1,000%. I will say this, that the next time a guy signs a 1+1 deal and then tears his Achilles, we are going to be sitting at this desk talking about how this is a cautionary tale, that if they put 5 years and $200-something million on the table in front of you, maybe you don't turn it down because health is always an uncertain factor.
But if you're, to Jalen's point, if you're a player at the level of Kawhi Leonard, at the level of Kevin
Durant,
I just said the Warriors are going to offer Kevin Durant a 5-year, $200 million contract with a torn Achilles in his 30s.
How much of that is guilt? How much? Why?
None.
You're going to do that to then trade him?
I think some of it is a little bit of guilt there.
They told him this wouldn't happen, and then he went out and it happened.
If they don't
make it right to make it right, it looks very bad.
It's not. Kevin Durant going to get paid regardless. That goes back to my initial point, whether it's with the Warriors or somebody else. There are only maybe 5 to 10 players in the league, Greeny, that understand they have a level of value, that they don't have to get all of the money from the team right now because the numbers outside of the sport are so exponentially high in endorsements and appearances, and now you keep your flexibility. That's the game,
okay.
Flexibility.
So let's just recap. We started the program 19 and a half minutes ago. In that time, we have learned that the Knicks might actually be in it for Kevin Durant and Kawhi Leonard.
Well, Kawhi. If you're excited about being in it, then good for you.
Listen.
They almost got Zion.
Being in it. These have been the best 19 minutes the Knicks have had in the last 20 years.
Fair enough.
Wendy,
it's a low bar.
Give me what I can get. Okay. I'll take it if that's the best you're offering. Okay.
This is irresponsible.
So this is the kind of morning that we got here, obviously.
I got one more Knick thing for you. R.J. Barrett continues to get slept on.
Yep.
He's going to be really good in
NBA. They're very excited about him.
Yes,
he
wants to be there. Good player.
No, in my opinion, he's the best player in this draft. I don't know who's sleeping on R.J. Barrett, but it's not me. What's going on outside?
It's so foggy.